This is your Asian session preview for Tuesday, January the 18th, 2011. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Please be advised the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. It is not an alert service. Coaches will not make trade recommendations. However, we will provide technical and fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans throughout the course of your trading day. Please bear in mind when trading heavily leveraged, it's a very risky business. Also, please remember past performance is not indicative of any future results. And we do not want you to trade any form of money you cannot afford to lose. That means you wouldn't be able to trade much longer, and that's not what we want. We want you to stay in this game as long as possible. Check out this DX chart here really quickly, guys. I'm going to throw this up here. I just want to highlight this on the daily chart. Support. So the fourth time at support, formerly resistance. So safe to say, and I bet if I zoomed out here, we've probably been in the 79 area before. But the most important thing for me is these Bollinger Bands. This upper Bollinger Band looks to be curling over, and we've got this wide open hello, how you doing, Bollinger Band to the bottom. Tells me for sure that we're going to get some continued USD weakness here. It's been an interesting couple of weeks, thin market weeks, I think holiday period, lacking direction, a little bit like a rudderless ship. If you just look at price action on this daily chart, it looked like we're going to get some, we're finding a bottom here, and then we got this high that broke these previous highs. It looked like this, euro, pound are going to come down. We were going to get something like this. Well, it's not to be. And I think you need to go with what you're seeing in your latest data or latest intel. And to me, for sure, it looks like this is the direction we're looking to kick off from. And in fact, I think we could kick off from anywhere where we are right now. That's why I'm making this video a little bit early. For Asia, just to get something out there for you guys to digest. Let's go along to the euro charts and take a little look here. Let's just go to the longer term stuff. Here's the daily chart here. Now, I sort of had this in descending parallel sort of trap here, but you can see that it's Bollinger Bands as well. This bottom one curled up to the top, nice and open. And the last couple of days, we've actually lived above this daily 200. Now, we're at the 134 psych level, but that can just be used as resistance. And now we're coming off the daily 5. I believe this is like the exact inverse of what that DX chart. And it looks to me like we are wanting to do this sort of thing. There's the euro relatively weaker than, say, the pound. If I just show you the pound really quickly. Here's the daily chart on the pound. I've zoomed out a little bit just to show you that we're clearly breaking a roll reversal area. I just want to highlight, here's resistance, lots of resistance in here before, resistance, now support, further resistance broken. So, something like this on the pound in the future, not that out of the question. But what I just wanted to highlight with this is the pound is long against the USD. I think you look at the yen, it's short against the USD, so Swissy short. So yeah, euro trying to head up. I think we'll just focus on the euro for the day and see if we can get any trade plans. Now, in terms of our EMA, this is the 4-hour chart here. In terms of our EMA theory that we've been speaking about lately in bootcamp, 21.55 cross to the upside. Now definitely back in that little zone. If you throw Fibonacci out there as well, it's pretty much a 382 of the rise. Somewhere around these parts, I think there's a real chance that we're going to get this sort of deal. And just get things to truck on up the road here. Also, check out the pivot points. Start with the hourly on the daily pivot points on the hourly chart here. This fulfills my little strategy that I have, that if you've got a central pivot uptrend, so you've got a trend happening, a market is moving, and you pull back to the S2 to M1 zone, which is a pretty much a take profit zone in this case to the downside, well, I like to look at that as also a buying opportunity. If people are taking profit, also potential for people to buy in the context of the longer term trend, which is definitely looks in that direction. So looking to get long from there, which is seems to be working out right now, which is very good. And also check out the weekly pivots. We fulfilled a very nice week last week. Basically rode from one extreme to the other, got out at M4 on Thursday, Friday. But look what we're kicking off as well. Weekly central. Daily extremes, weekly central. So you've got multiple levels of pivot support in the same area. I've seen that a million times. Although this 4-hour Bollinger Bands are closed, you know, wait for a few candles, we'll see what happens. But to me, it all spells out in that direction, looking to get long the euro, and I'd be quite confident in trying to run that thing up, seeing if it's going to want to hit up into that 136, 137 area throughout the course of the week. I think there's a real possibility. We're going to start getting some real money back in the markets these weeks. Last few weeks, holiday season action, thinner markets, but I think we're going to start seeing a lot more money coming in. Other things we've been looking at, by the way, awesome marathon at Bootcamp last week. If you missed it, you missed a real treat. And if we have another one, which I'm sure we will have another one or two this year, basically 24 hours a day coaching for an entire week. A lot of people got some really good things out of it, and we met a lot of new people and new faces at Bootcamp, which was always good. And I know a lot of those people will be back this week, so looking forward to some coaching. One thing was this trap on the 4-hour is broken clearly to the downside. This is the USD yen. So USD weakness, and I'm looking for that. Pretty much not far from where we are as well. Just like the euro, I think, could get long any time. I think this USD yen could get long. The reason why we had it trapped, we just had a lot of price hesitation last week in this fib on the daily area. And it's broken to the downside, which to me, you have to take as being the next direction. And so it's worth a little trade. And I think we're going to... I think we can run this thing down. I think there's a real potential to get it back to this. I've got this upward rising support line here, joining these lows through here. I think that's the next stop. If breaks that, hello 80 and hello some new lows. Okay, I'm going to call it a day there, guys. Basically, essentially, the theme of the day is just continued USD weakness. And I think there's some further opportunities to continue that general trend. Have yourselves a good trading day, and we'll catch you in Bootcamp. Cheers.